Hi friends, so it's me, Rylan. Welcome back to my channel if you were already along on this journey of life with me, and if you're new, hello! And there goes my camera. Great start. Great start. But today I wanted to, also it's May 4th, Tuesday, May 4th at 11:37 in 2020. So I wanted to make a video today about what I always say. I've been reading to talk about this and I haven't made a video. Well, here I am. I'm making a video about how going to therapy is normal. There are so many misconceptions and stigma in like mainstream media, whether it be TV or movies, about going to therapy, that it just makes me want to rip my face off. Specifically, I was watching a really trashy reality TV show, but I don't care. I watched all 10 seasons. But in one of the episodes, this one girl like insulted another woman, yelling at her and saying like, "You need to go to therapy." And it was thrown as an insult, as if that's a bad thing. And another common thing that I see in media is couples counseling and how big of a deal that is, of just like, "Oh my God, did you hear that Janet and Jerry are in couples counseling? I didn't realize it was that bad. Oh my God." No, it is hard being a human being. Life is filled with stressors every single day, okay? Now, some people have trauma and some people have mental health conditions, and that adds on to how hard it is to be a human. Now, when it comes to the couples counseling thing, when you add two humans together in a relationship, each person has their own stuff, they have their own history, they have their own feelings, they have their own daily life. And then you bring that together and that can make magical things happen. But of course, not everything is going to be perfect. So you don't have to be at the end of your rope to be going to couples therapy or couples counseling, whatever you want to call it. It's maintenance. I look at therapy as maintenance. We brush our teeth. We maybe go to the gym. We go to the doctor's office. We do all of these things. I say that mental health is as important as dental health. Because it's like, why do we put all of that stuff above our brain, which is like how we function throughout the day in the world and interact with people? Why wouldn't we want to like make some tweaks if necessary or just get more support? So yeah, I'm really sick of seeing that trope of couples therapy. And therapy, I was just watching an episode of a TV show, and it's a show on a very big network, and someone revealed to his sister, he's like, "You know what, I've been seeing a therapist," and she was just like, "Oh my God, what's wrong?" There doesn't have to be anything wrong. That's the point I'm trying to make. There doesn't have to be anything wrong with you in life. That's the biggest thing I hear of reasons that people feel they don't need to go to therapy. "Oh, well, I'm fine. I have friends. I'm good, blah, blah, blah." We all have things that we struggle with, and it's okay to take an hour a week, every other week, once a month, to talk to somebody that is trained. It's different than talking to your best friends. Like, props to the best friends that will listen to you vent for 3 hours about whatever is ailing you. But having a professional who has a completely removed relationship from the people in your life and can look at the things that you're dealing with objectively is a godsend. They're able to give you insight that you didn't even have, or maybe some patterns in your life that if you realize them, maybe you can unravel them a little bit and life might be a little easier. So it doesn't have to be big dramatic things in your life. The fact that you're breathing right now, I feel like warrants therapy. I've never said that before, but I'm saying it now. And then, you know, I'm going to acknowledge the fact that therapy isn't accessible to everybody. A lot of times it requires health insurance. And if it's not covered by health insurance, it can be expensive. And I realize we don't all have money for that. And so that's where I say there are so many community health centers around the world that probably offer free counseling. Usually it's like short-term therapy, and short-term therapy is considered 3 months. But 3 months is better than no months. And also, there are so many support groups, so many support organizations that, especially now during COVID, there are. I work for the National Alliance on Mental Illness, and the branch that I work at, I think we have over 100 support groups a month. Like, I think the last numbers I checked was 9,000 people were coming to our meetings because stuff is really difficult right now and has gotten even harder for people during COVID. So especially now, this is the time to reach out. So yeah, that's an option if you don't have the money, because I understand it's expensive. And the last thing I want to acknowledge is that I understand that it is extremely daunting and even terrifying or just annoying to be like, why do I have to talk to a stranger? They don't know anything about me. Like, why would I want to tell them, you know, my deep, dark shit? And to that I say is, again, this person isn't going to judge you. You could say probably the worst thoughts in your mind, the most difficult things that you've struggled with. And if they are a good therapist, they're not going to judge you. They're going to sit there and listen with open ears, hopefully a kind face, and just listen and work with you. So if you feel like whatever you have to say is either insignificant or too much, there's no judgment. And if you do have a therapist that does make you feel uncomfortable, they're making you feel judged, you can find another one. There is something called terminating with a therapist, and I've had to do it a couple times. I have left, I think, 3 come to mind that it just wasn't working out and I didn't feel comfortable with them. But if you work with someone you feel comfortable with, your life can change. So those are the things that I wanted to talk about. And me personally, my therapy journey, I've been in therapy, I think, for the past 12 years voluntarily. And for the past 6 years, I go twice a week, y'all. And I'm on meds because I have bipolar disorder and I have generalized anxiety. I'm not afraid to admit those things. And I don't think there should be any shame in admitting that you're going to talk to somebody. I think that takes bravery, quite frankly. I think it's okay and brave to say, like, either, hey, I'm struggling with something and I need help. Or if you're not struggling with someone, hey, I could use someone to talk to. I need an hour of me time this week. So I encourage you to maybe tweak a little bit of the way that you look at therapy if you look at it as a negative or a goddamn sign of weakness, because it's not. As I said, being a human is fucking hard. So why would we want to take that journey alone? So going to therapy is normal, y'all. There's nothing wrong with it. Absolutely nothing at all. So have a good day. And if it's not a good day, just have a day. All right. Until next time, my friends.